Welcome back, everybody. He's a creator of the popular food blog, Fit Man Cook, where he's teaching the world how to make healthy food without sacrificing flavor. I like him already. And today, he's here with a recipe for savory, spicy, low-carb jambalaya. Welcome to our kitchen, Kevin Curry, everybody.
What's up, man?
Kevin, man.
How you doing?
I'm excited that you're here.
Thank you. The men are in the kitchen today.
That's right.
Wow.
That's right. That's right. That's how we're rolling here.
This is Deb, some spice.
Wow. Debbie's already got it on her spoon. She's ready to go. Kim, Orly, Larissa.
I had a taste, Cameron, and I put hair on my chest.
Oh, wow.
That's good. Literally put
that's
hair on my
chest.
That's
called love in the cell.
That's what I mean. I'm telling you right now.
This is
a genius idea. Basically, you say that you've given comfort food a makeover here.
Absolutely.
Tell me about that.
It's the same comfort food recipe, but it's calorie conscious. So when you finish eating it, you're going to feel better.
Which is so
that's
important.
The most important.
That's how I like to live.
I am going to feel better because this spice is going to clear out my mind. It's got a little spice. It does have that post-comfort food blow.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you wake up energized.
And we've talked about this before. We talk about these great food swaps you can do in different recipes to make it a little bit healthier. The main one in this dish is substituting traditional rice with cauliflower rice.
Get rid of the simple carbs and put in some cauliflower rice.
How did you come about this cauliflower rice? What's the way to do it?
Put into a blender.
Okay.
And just pulse blend it until it creates this rice-like texture. Now, cauliflower has a whole bunch of water.
Yes.
So if you don't squeeze out the moisture, it's going to get really soggy.
Because that has happened to me.
Yeah,
right.
Exactly.
So that's the secret.
Right here, squeeze it out. Look at all this.
Oh,
look at all that water that comes out.
Okay, because otherwise it gets really saucy, really soupy,
really,
the recipe,
really soupy,
right?
Yeah. So you do this twice.
Now,
this
can you reuse cheesecloths, or do you throw it out after you?
You can, but you know what? I'm squeezing so hard this kind of bursts through.
Yeah, yeah, I heard you. I mean, he works out a little bit, everybody. He's in the gym a little bit. Okay. So we've got our cauliflower rice. I know we've also got our olive oil. We got some garlic in here, some onions, we got some chicken, some turkey sausage. How long has this been on the stove? How long have we been cooking this?
For about 5 minutes here.
Okay, five minutes.
Let's get this going, let's get some smells going. Mm-hmm. And now we're gonna add in some personalities.
Oh, yeah, a lot of personalities. Asian food is all about the spice. It's hard to smell good.
So this is some oregano.
Okay, get a little oregano in there.
We've got some thyme.
Oh, yes.
We've got some smoked paprika. And then we're gonna add in the heat.
Okay.
Gotta add a little bit of cayenne.
I've been hearing about that cayenne.
Yeah.
It's a little bit too much for y'all West Coast. It's very good. Well, it's perfect.
I like spicy.
It smells amazing. Okay, so then you add some veggies, right? Yeah, just a little bit.
So now we're gonna toss in some bell pepper.
Oh.
Beautiful.
All right. Some crunch.
I mean, there's nothing that's going in here that isn't super healthy. I'm looking at you, Kim, because I know you watch all this. Yeah.
So this is some celery.
Great. Great. That's probably my agent calling.
That was your agent.
It's all right.
Smelled it across the way. All right, here's some tomatoes.
Okay, good.
Give that a good stir.
Okay.
I got that. You know, Fit Man Cook, bro. Go on him.
That's it. Listen, I'm trying.
You are really fit. So I've seen your Instagram. You're very fit.
I try.
You can go ahead and do
that. But I appreciate that Cameron is wearing the apron, isn't
he? Yeah.
Well, you know what I mean?
Anyone noticing that?
I try to look the part, everybody. I try to look the part. So a little tomato paste in there as well?
Some tomato paste.
Okay.
Some thickener.
Beautiful.
All right.
And you got to really work that in there, too.
I know. I like that you're cooking when you're talking about fit men.
Right.
Yeah. You're like, Cameron had to get in there.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I would feel really funny if I was at the counter for this segment. I'm telling you right now.
Yeah.
Okay.
Here's some broth.
Can you
use a little bit of chicken stock, or you can use some veggie broth if you want as well.
How about bone broth? Can you do a little bone broth swap out?
You can do some bone broth.
Yeah, sure. Okay, good.
Up the protein. And then a little bit of tomato sauce.
Okay.
You're going to bring this to a simmer, and then get your salt bay on. Once you get a little salt bay action, go ahead and let it hit.
Do you see the reaction?
Yeah, they're so disappointed.
Please don't judge me. Please don't judge me.
Let's see how it's done.
Here it is. Just.
You let it rain.
There you go. Just keep going for it. There you go.
I mean, we don't have to. One more time.
Hey. There we go.
Whatever.
Listen, one of the things, other than the fact
that you're humiliating me in front of everybody at home that watches the show, no, I love the fact that you talk about creating new memories with these meals, with changing them, because sometimes you're going to taste something like this, and it's not going to maybe be the jambalaya that you know, but you're creating new memories.
Absolutely, and that's the most important part. You want to create new memories with food. So this is the cauliflower rice.
Okay.
So
it's so much better with the cauliflower rice.
It's still really wholesome and filling. And then we're going to top this.
But it doesn't bog you down, like you said.
You won't have that bloat afterwards. And that's the most important thing.
And it's okay to put it in
to make you feel good. Yeah. And after this, you're going to top it off with this, you know, with some shrimp.
And it's going to cook in there. That's enough time. So you let this simmer for a while until the shrimp cooks up.
And where's the lid? We can top this off with the lid.
I'm telling you right now.
How long do you cook it for, Mr. Cup?
You can cook this for about 10, 15 minutes, bring it to a light simmer, and then afterwards it's gonna look like this.
It's gonna look like this beauty right here. Fit Men Cook, everybody. Fit Men Cook.
Look at what Cameron did.
This is what I created.
He is killing it in the kitchen.
I made this for you, man.
Oh, thank you.
No problem.
Wow. You are killing it today.
I love it. This is genius. I want to point this out before I have a little taste here. I also want to say one of the things I love that you talk about is a, you know, we all talk about having treats when we're trying to eat a little bit healthier.
But
Kevin talks about treat meals instead of treat days.
Don't have an entire day. And also, if you plan for it, it's not a cheat. It's a treat for you. It's a part of your healthy, balanced diet. And that's what we all need.
I'm amazing.
Fantastic. Yeah. And I've just become part of the Clean Plate Club.
Oh, my gosh.
This is really great.
I told you. That is delicious.
Yeah, come on. Bring it in. Bring it.
Thank you so much.
This recipe is available on our website. And to pick up your own copy of Kevin's book, you can head on over to fitmencook.com.